Welcome back to our special election coverage here at CBNNews.com. I'm Mark Martin. We're breaking into our regular programming on the CBN News Channel to bring you an update on the battle to control the U.S. Senate. And the first big Senate takeaway for Republicans tonight, Shelley Moore Capito has won in West Virginia. She took the seat that was just vacated by retiring Democrat Jay Rockefeller. Capito soundly defeated Democrat Natalie Tennant. Our chief political correspondent, David Brody, joins us from the nation's capital. David, what helped Capito take this seat in West Virginia?
Well, I got to tell you, Mark, it wasn't even close. I mean, quite frankly, this was something that she positioned herself well, nice and early, especially as it relates to the coal manufacturing out in West Virginia and this idea that energy was going to be her meal ticket, if you will, to the Senate. And so, look, this is a state that is not in love with the president at all. One of the lowest approval numbers that the president has comes from West Virginia. And of course, that helped her quite immensely. And so this was really no surprise. And remember, Mark, this is one of those three states, Montana, South Dakota, West Virginia, that the Republicans believed all along they would pick up tonight. And so indeed, this is a pickup. In other words, a switch from a Democrat seat to a Republican seat, because that Democrat was Jay Rockefeller. He has retired. Shelley Moore Capito now picking up that seat. And indeed, the Republicans are on their way to a potential Senate majority. We will see a lot of the tough races still in play tonight.
All right. And when West Virginia's neighbor, Ohio Governor John Kasich, is headed to a second term, soundly defeating his challenger, Ed Fitzgerald. Kasich's big win in a major state is seen as boosting him as a possible 2016 presidential candidate. David, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, this is a guy that has positioned himself all along as someone that can play ball with Democrats, but yet, and here's the key, Mark, not alienate himself with the conservative base of the Republican Party. So he's done a very good job. Look, he is from a swing state of Ohio, and of course, Ohio is always very, very important in presidential politics. And so basically, the sell for John Kasich, if you will, if he did decide to run for president, is that this is a guy that can carry a very important state that Republicans are going to need to take back the White House, as in Ohio. And so this is a good night for him. We're obviously going to be watching what happens out in Wisconsin with Scott Walker. The polls there closing shortly as it relates to whether or not he can yet win again. It seems like he's been trying to win re-election ever since he became governor a few years ago. He also is interested in potentially running for president, but he's got to win re-election tonight.
David, one of the biggest surprises of the night so far is how close things are in the Virginia Senate race. David, was this expected at all?
Oh, no, Mark, it really wasn't. Look, I think the conventional wisdom was that how are you going to beat a Mark Warner who did not come across necessarily as a polarizing guy in Capitol Hill? He wasn't necessarily a Harry Reid Democrat, though Ed Gillespie was trying to paint him that way. This was a guy that pretty much carved a reputation as an independent, as a moderate. I mean, he was a Democrat, but he was kind of independent minded, if you will. And so, no, I mean, look, it's too close to call in Virginia. I have to tell you, I just came from the Republican National Committee, Mark, and I can tell you that Reince Priebus, the Republican National Committee chairman, just told me that he saw eight camera crews leave the Republican National Committee headquarters because they were going to do a press conference there later today. They left and they went where? To Virginia. They went to Northern Virginia, where that seems, at least at this point, to be a big story tonight. Could Ed Gillespie literally pull off the upset against Mark Warner? Hey, listen, Mark, if that's the case, we're not talking about a mini wave here. We're talking about a major wave. It's too close to determine right now, but that is something to keep your eye on for sure.
It sure is. All right, David, we'll check in with you later this evening. Thanks for the updates.
Thanks, Mark.
And stay with CBN News all night for updates right here on our news channel. We're going to be live at 15 minutes after the hour and at 15 minutes before, or watch on demand anytime. Plus, we'll have more reporting on CBNNews.com and on our special election page, including a live Twitter feed for you to follow the tweets by our reporters. And our news team here in the CBN News studios and in our Washington Bureau, of course, will also be posting updates on Facebook. You can follow us at #CBNElection2014. We'll be back at 8:15 Eastern with the latest on some of the races. In the meantime, stay with us online for continuous updates.